talking about. Just what I came after. Oh, you nuts. Like 7 pounds?
Oh, yeah, we got somebody.
Oh my God! Oh shit! Ah! Ah! Got it! Holy crap! Oh. There we go. That's a nice one there. That's a bass. Large bass. First fish of the day. The first one was a crappie because I seen it. And it is little by definition. Literally little. Alright. Wow. State record. Attracts a bigger fish in return. Got it. Now that ain't a bad one. All right. Oh, it's a bass. Thought it was a crappie. He's a whole 2 inches bigger than the last one. Makes it 8 inches. I thought it was a crappie. So it's actually small for a bass, tiny. Got him. Oh, it's bigger. Finally a decent bass. Not bad for a year. Hey, patience paid off. All right. Hey, hey. What's up, mister? Mr. Largemouth. Well, if the quapper ain't cooperating, at least the bass will, I guess. It's better. It's still not even a pound, but it's better. There we go, on the jig, guys. Slab daddy jig, and it's a big crappie. All right, now we're talking. I'm gonna have to walk around this lake. I'm using a lime chartreuse and yellow slab daddy jig. First time trying it, first cast trying it. lime chartreuse head, yellow body, and a lime tail. Pretty cool. They come in little three packs. Not a bad little white. About eight incher. To start, yeah, I'm already confident with this jig. Very confident. Alright, I just got fish. Another tiny 8-inch bass. Switched my lure. Gave up on bass for a little bit. I'll go back to them. What I'm using here is a Bobby Garland, but I can't remember what they're called. It's the hollow tail. There we go, folks. Big one. Yes. Oh, yeah. Big. Oh, it's a pickerel. Oh, man. And he got off. Darn. He was actually small for a pickerel. But it was a fish. He was only about 13 or 14 inches. Slab. I think that's what it is. I could be wrong. It could be a bass or pickerel, I guess. It's acting like a crappie, though. Nope, it's a bluegill. Oh, and it's a monster, though. Nice bluegill. Man. Gosh. Boy, they're getting big in here compared to last year. I didn't get but one or two of these all last year this big. I bet he's every bit of 10 inches. Folks, that's a big bluegill. That's nice. Nice size bluegill. Wow. Hey, at least I got something. It's really been slow, guys. Dead slow. I regret not stopping to get minnows now, but it is way too late. No turning back. There we go. Oh, I think he got, no, he's still on there. Now we're talking, but it's not a crappie because it jumped. It's a bass. Hey, it's a fish. Nice large mouth, huh? Not bad. Right in front of that brush pile over there. Yeah, it's not that big. A pound. Caught him on a half yellow. Oh, it's a cream. It's the brand. K-R-E-M-E. Cream. 2-inch curly tail, half pink, half yellow with a white tail. I'm just happy to get something. All I got was that bluegill and this bass. It has been slow. Worst mistake I made, not coming with minnows, guys. Always bringing live bait as a backup plan. You just see what happened. It was just dead slow. They were biting, but not chasing. The best way to describe it. There we go. Right from the tree, guys. I got a crappie right before dark, finally. Yes, vertical jigging, guys, and they are gold now. That's what I'm talking about. It finally paid off right at the end. It's almost dark. Nice crappie. 11 inches, black, golden color, beautiful crappie, guys. Vertical jigging this tree. They have been hard to find, hard today. If I would have brought minnows, I probably could have caught 20. Folks, I finally got a crappie. I have been fishing for 2 hours. This is the smallest one I've caught out of here in a long time. He's only about 9 inches. But hey, I'm happy to get anything. It has been awful. Little black, 9-incher. Finally a fish though. I mean, this is just horrible how slow it's been. We had a cold front come through yesterday, and I think that's what caused these fish to just turn off. Let's see if I can get another one real quick. I got about 10 minutes or less. All right.